Subscribe to Simplified Biology channel and press the bell icon to get notified when a new video is uploaded. Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. Today we'll solve some more MCQs of cell cycle and cell division. Please solve the questions by clicking on the link above before going through the solution. Question 1. In mitosis, the daughter cells resemble the parent cell. But in meiosis, they differ not only from the parent cell in having half the number of chromosomes, but also differ among themselves qualitatively in genetic constitution due to A. segregation and crossing over only, B. independent assortment and segregation only, C. crossing over, independent assortment and segregation, D. independent assortment and crossing over only. Mitosis is an equational division due to which the daughter cells produce are completely identical to the parent cell. But meiosis is a reductional division in which crossing over takes place, leading to variations. And it occurs prior to the gamete formation. During gamete formation, the chromosomes, they segregate from each other. Independent assortment of genes occur and they form all possible combinations in the gametes. So the answer will be C, that is crossing over, independent assortment and segregation. Question 2. Select the incorrectly matched pair. Phragmoplast. It is a persistent spindle or the remains of spindle at the centermost part. Reductional division, meiosis 1 is a reductional division. Equational division, meiosis 2 is an equational division. Crossing over and non-homologous chromosomes. Crossing over always occurs between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. So, the incorrect pair is D, that is crossing over and non-homologous chromosomes. Question 3. The number of meiotic divisions required to produce 400 grains is 100, 800, 500, 300. Grains are the seeds. Seeds are fertilized ovule. Now the simple formula to do this is N plus N by 4. N is the number of seeds, 400 plus 400 divided by 4. That is 100. So 400 plus 100, that equals to 500. Now to form a 400 fertilized ovules or to form 400 fertilized seeds, we require 400 pollens or the male gametes and 400 egg. To form 400 pollens, we require 400 divided by 4, that is 100 divisions, meiotic divisions, while to form 400 eggs, we require 400 meiotic divisions. As during oogenesis, of the 4 daughter cells that are produced, 3 degenerate and only 1 behaves as the functional egg. While in spermatogenesis, all the 4 daughter cells act as functional pollens. So 100 plus 400, that equals to 500. So C is the correct option, 500. Question 4. A bivalent consists of 2 chromatids and 1 centromere, 4 chromatids and 2 centromere, 2 chromatids and 2 centromere, 4 chromatids and 4 centromere. Now bivalent are formed due to pairing up of homologous chromosomes, that is synapses. Each then splits up into 2 chromatids attached at the centromere. So a bivalent consists of 4 chromatids and 2 centromeres. So B is the correct option, that is 4 chromatids and 2 centromeres. Question 5. Segregation of Mendelian factors occur during diplotene, anaphase 1, zygotene pachytene, anaphase 2. Now, alleles of a gene are present at homologous sites in homologous chromosomes. These chromosomes, homologous chromosomes, are first paired to form bivalents, and then they divide to form two chromatids attached at the centromere, forming a tetrad during which crossing over takes place. After which the chromosomes, they start moving towards the poles. That is, the homologous chromosomes separate during anaphase 1. As the homologous chromosomes separate, Mendelian factors also separate. So segregation of Mendelian factors occur during anaphase 1 of meiosis. So answer is B. Question 6. Match the following. Column 1 with column 2. Cytokinesis, metaphase, telophase, interphase. Reformation of nuclear membrane and Golgi body. Synthesis of RNA and protein. Centromere of chromosomes are arranged on equatorial plate. Contraction of cell membrane starts. Cytokinesis is division of the cytoplasm, which occurs due to constriction of cell membrane in case of animal cells. So A and 4 can be paired. B, metaphase. During metaphase, the centromeres of the chromosomes arrange themselves on the equatorial plate. So, the centromeres come to lie on the equatorial plate. So, B is 3. Telophase, the last stage of prophase, where the chromosomes have reached the poles, uncoiling starts, nucleolus and the nuclear membrane reappear. So, C, telophase is with first one, that is reformation of nuclear membrane and Golgi body. And D, that is interphase. During interphase, synthesis of RNA and protein occurs. So D2. In the first A option, A1, this is not there. B option, A4, B3, C1, D2. So B is the correct option. Question 7. Passage through which checkpoint is the step which commits the cell to proceed through to mitosis and cell division? G1 to S, S to G2, G2 to M, and M to G1. Now, when G1 is the most variable phase with regard to time taken, as the cell enters the S phase, DNA replication starts and completes. So, once the cell enters the S phase, it cannot go to the G0 phase. It is in the G1 stage that the cell can go to the G0 phase, that is the quiescent stage. But once it has passed through the G1 stage to the S phase, it is committed to divide. So the answer here is G1 to S. Question 8. Which is not characteristic of meiosis? A, two stage of DNA replication, first before meiosis 1 and second before meiosis 2. B, recombination and crossing over. C, sister chromatids separate during anaphase 2. D, nuclear membrane disappears towards the end of prophase. A option, that is two stages of DNA replication occurs. Now, DNA replication occurs only once, whether it is in meiosis or mitosis, that is prior to meiosis 1. So this option is wrong. Second, recombination and crossing over takes place. This is a characteristic of meiosis. Third, sister chromatids separate during anaphase 2. This too is a characteristic where centromere splits and the sister chromatids separate from each other. D, nuclear membrane disappears towards the end of prophase. This also is a characteristic of meiosis. So the correct option is A, that is two stages of DNA replication, first up before meiosis and second before meiosis 2 occurs. This is wrong, or this is not the characteristic of meiosis. Question 9. Match the following. Prophase 1, metaphase 2, anaphase 1, telophase 1. In column 2, the first option is chromosomes move towards one plane along with centromere. Now this occurs during metaphase. So B is with 1, paired with 1. Metaphase 2, the chromosome move towards one plane along with centromere. Second, half the number of chromosomes is C. Now during anaphase 1, the homologous chromosomes separate from each other. Hence, half the number of chromosomes are seen in each pole. So 2 is with anaphase 1, that is C. Longest phase of meiosis 1, that is prophase 1, which is divided into 3 substages. So A is with 3. And 2 nuclei are seen, that is 2 nuclei can be seen at the end of meiosis 1, that is telophase 1. So 4 is with D. A 3, B 1, C 2, D 4. So the correct option here is A. Question 10. Diploid chromosome number being 8, what shall be the number of chromatids in each daughter after meiosis 1? 16, 8, 4, 2. Now the diploid number, 2n number is 8. After meiosis 1, which is the redactional division, the chromosome number is 4. Each chromosome has 2 chromatids. So, in total, there are 4 into 2, 8 chromatids can be seen. So, the correct answer is B, that is 8. Question 11. A somatic cell has just completed the S phase of its life cycle as compared to gametes of the same species, has same number of chromosomes but twice the amount of DNA, twice the number of chromosomes and 4 times the amount of DNA, 4 times the amount of chromosomes and twice the amount of DNA, twice the number of chromosomes and twice the amount of DNA. Now gametes are haploid, having half the number of chromosomes, while somatic cells are diploid, means having 2n chromosomes. So the somatic cell will have twice the number of chromosomes, and since it has passed through S phase, DNA replication has occurred, so the amount of DNA will be 4n, as this 2n has duplicated. So the somatic cell will have twice the number of chromosomes and 4 times the amount of DNA. Question 12. During which phase of cell cycle, amount of DNA in a cell remains at 4c? If the initial amount is denoted as 2C. Now during G1 stage, the amount of DNA is 2C, or the cell that enters the G1 stage has 2C amount of DNA. During S phase, the 2C becomes 4C. G2 phase, 2 has 4C. While in the M phase, when the cell has divided, the daughter cells that are produced, they will have again 2C. So A option is G2 and M. This is not the option. B, G0 and G1. G0 means when the cell has stopped dividing and gets differentiated. The cell enters the G0 stage from G1 stage. So that too is not the answer. G1 and S. G1 is not the answer, and S, so this also is not the correct option. Only G2. Yeah, of the 4 in G2, the cell has 4C amount of DNA. So the correct option here is D. Question 13. Select the correct option with respect to mitosis. A choice, chromatids separate, but they remain in the center of the cell in anaphase. This is wrong because chromatids, after they separate, they start moving towards the pole during anaphase. B option, chromatids start moving towards opposite poles in telophase. No, this occurs during anaphase, so this is also the wrong option. C, Golgi complex and endoplasmic reticulum are still visible at the end of prophase. The Golgi complex and endoplasmic reticulum are not visible, so this is also not the correct option. D, the chromosomes move to the spindle equator and get aligned along equatorial plate in metaphase. In metaphase, the chromosomes arrange themselves on the equatorial plate, so this is the correct option. The answer is D. Question 14. Synaptinemal complex helps in disjunction, proper alignment of homologous chromosomes, congression, all of the above. Synaptinemal complex can be seen between homologous chromosomes during pairing of homologous chromosomes. Disjunction means separation of chromosomes. At this time, it doesn't help in disjunction. Proper alignment of homologous chromosomes. This is correct. Synaptinemal complex helps in pairing up of the homologous chromosomes, or it helps in precise pairing of homologous chromosomes. Question 15. At dikinesis, a meiocyte has 10 pairs of chromosomes. The chromosome number expected in each nucleus is 10 at the end of first division, 5 at the end of second division, 10 at the end of first division and 10 at the end of second division, 5 at the end of first division and 5 at the end of second division, 20 at the end of first division and 10 at the end of second division. A meiocyte means a cell undergoing meiosis. It has 10 pairs of chromosomes at dikinesis. Dikinesis is the end of prophase 1. Meiosis 1 is a reductional division. So by the end of first division, it will have 10 chromosomes. And meiosis 2 is an equational division. So by the end of meiosis 2, it will also have 10 chromosomes. So B is the correct answer. That is 10 at the end of first division and 10 at the end of second division. Question 16. Synaptinemal complex is visible from leptotene through diplotene, pachytene through diplotene, zygotene through pachytene, diplotene to metaphase. Now, synaptinemal complex can be seen between homologous chromosomes when pairing occurs or when the bivalents are formed. It helps in precise pairing. And bivalents are formed during the zygotene stage. And this continues through the pachytene stage. The synaptinemal complex is present during pachytene stage. Crossing over occurs, after which the synaptinemal complex dissolves. So the answer is zygotene through pachytene. That is the C option. Question 17. At which stage does cytokinesis typically starts? Interphase, late metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Cytokinesis starts during mid-anaphase. That is when the chromosomes start moving towards the poles, and it ends by the end of telophase. So cytokinesis starts during anaphase. C is the correct option. Question 18. During a cell cycle, the transition from G1 to S phase and from G2 to M phase requires the activation of which of the following? A, inducer enzyme, B, ATP, C, cyclin, D, cyclin and CDK complex. The transition from one phase to another phase is controlled by cyclin and cyclin dependent kinase enzymes? So the correct option is D. Question 19. Which statement about mitosis is false? A. Telophase is defined at the stage at which all the chromosomes arrive at the equatorial plate and the centromere begins to divide. This is wrong, as this occurs during metaphase. B. Replication of DNA occurs during S phase of the cell cycle, which is a part of interphase. This is true in case of both mitosis and meiosis. C. At the onset of mitosis, the chromatin becomes highly organized as a result of supercoiling. This too is correct. D. Mitosis refers only to the division of nucleus, but is followed by cytokinesis most often. This too is correct. So the only wrong statement is A. So the answer is A. Last question. Arrange the following events of meiosis in proper order. Terminalization of chiasmata, crossing over, synapses, disjunction of chromosomes, dissolution of synaptonemal complex. Now, in meiosis, the first step is synapses, that is pairing up of homologous chromosomes. After synapses, crossing over takes place. And during synapses, synaptonemal complex is formed, which gets dissolved after crossing over has taken place. So next will be dissolution of synaptonemal complex. After crossing over and dissolving of synaptonemal complex, the homologous chromosomes try to separate, chiasma are seen, and then terminalization occurs. So next is terminalization 1. This is in prophase 1. In metaphase 1, the chromosomes arrange themselves on the equatorial plate. And in anaphase 1, the homologous chromosomes separate from each other. That is, disjunction of chromosomes occur. That is 4. So the correct order is 3, 2, 5, 1 and 4. That is, D is the correct answer. That's all for today. Please do like, comment and subscribe, and also visit our website by clicking on the link given below. Thank you for watching.